What is your thank God it was just a dream moment? My dream started with me waking up from coma and discovering that I have been in coma for 8 years. My parents were dead, my brother was dead, my friends weren't there anymore. I was all alone, realizing that I have nobody in my life and that best years of my life have been wasted. This dream was different from my other dreams. This dream felt very, very real and realistic. Usually I can control my dreams, but I was powerless in this one. The feeling of panic, hope and sadness was so strong that I killed myself, and that is when I woke up. Although I was panicking a little bit afterwards and feeling that this actually happened, I was very relieved that I woke up. Whoa, that's intense. Glad you noped out of that timeline. I am glad that I got out of there too. That was one of my biggest fears, and since it was so realistic, it really felt like a nightmare that came to life. I'm curious, when you woke up for real, did you question if this world was the afterlife for a moment? I only ask because I have this recurring theme in some of my dreams that I am driving and the brakes just stop working. Sometimes I am able to swerve to a stop, but most times it leads to my in-dream death followed by waking up. One time I careened off a tall cliff edge and I had about 10 seconds to contemplate my death. In that moment I accepted completely that I was about to die and there was absolutely nothing I could do about it. When I woke up, I was in that post-wake-up haze and seriously believed for the first 5 seconds that this was the afterlife. After I fully woke up, I just had to sit up and contemplate what I just went through for 5 minutes before I could get up and do anything. I fell off a cliff and died. For some reason I didn't wake up. My dream even had a small funeral service scene for me. Press F to pay respects. F. Going to school naked. Dude, I've had too many of those in elementary. Trying to hide behind desks and crap and everyone just looking at you like a freak. Horrible and embarrassing as hell. I feel like everybody has had that dream at least once. I recently had a dream that my dog died. My sister came up to me and just told me. I had no recollection of him dying, and in that moment she told me, I had to do my best to hold back tears. I was so confused during the dream because the news just blindsided me. The next morning, I woke up and saw him sitting in his little bed. It was quite the scare. I saw a dream where one of my pets died, and it happened 2 weeks after seeing the dream. This just happened pretty recently. That I was pregnant. I'm a guy, but it felt so realistic. As a pregnant lady, last night I had a dream that my baby kicked so hard I had baby legs sticking out of my stomach from a huge hole. As a pregnant lady currently being beaten from the inside out, this actually made me laugh. Maybe it would be different if it was a dream. Had one just this morning. In the dream, I discovered my husband having sex with my mother. I've had that dream a few times before, and it didn't make any sense to me. It would never happen IRL. But I realized that it usually occurred after days where I thought about her too much and remembered ways she used to purposely try and ruin my friendships and other relationships. I guess that is just the most extreme version of that my scumbag dreaming brain can come up with. Wet dream. Gay sex with a coworker. I'm not gay. Yet. Sometimes you just have to find the right person who makes you question your sexuality. I myself have caused many women to find out they're lesbians. Dreamt that my estranged stepbrother raped me while holding a knife inside my mouth. As he finished raping me, he stabbed me through the back of my throat. I felt it and heard the crunch, then woke up. Most terrible dream I've ever had. Well shit, I had a similar dream about my father, who had never done anything of the sort. Glad to know I'm not the only one. The real most terrible dream I ever had was when I fell from a 30-foot ladder and then spent 10 minutes in dream slowly dying, looking at my ribs sticking out of my chest. I've had plenty of horrific death dreams, but that's the only one that really dragged out the suffering. Was in the army as infantry, before I had a family and kids. I still have plenty of dreams where I'm going back over there and I'm just so worried about it all. Then I wake up and I'm like, oh thank God. Edit, I don't think I have PTSD. It's just dreams. I think most people normally dream about past jobs. They're not horrible dreams, just I know in my dreams I shouldn't be back in Afghanistan and yet there I am and I wondering why I got sent back. So in real life, my kittens have ringworm and we put them in quarantine, but it already passed to my dog, my sister, and my mom. For now, me and my dad are safe. In my dream, however, I'm thought I was safe until I turned my head and saw a huge mushroom growing on my shoulder. Ringworm is a fungus. My parents told me not to cut it off, but I accidentally brushed it off and it fell into the sink, but it morphed into a weird heart-looking thing and it started beating like one. Then I woke up, and I'm still pretty sure I'm ringworm free. For the past 3 weeks, I've been having these nightmares where I am back in school, all alone, unable to find my classes, failing my classes, missing the bus, and my bullies being much worse. I was bullied a lot when I was in school. I have sworn that I would never go to a brick and mortar school again after I graduated high school. One morning, I woke up, worried that I forgot my science homework. 5 minutes later, I realized I don't go to school anymore. That was a relief. I did this once. Woke up one morning, realizing I didn't do some homework assignment, I think English. Then I realized it was a Sunday morning. Then I realized I no longer went to school, hadn't been in over 20 years. I have dreams quite frequently where I'm wandering the hallways of my high school and can't figure out what class comes after lunch. I don't know why it makes me panic, since I skipped all the time anyway. Just this morning I dreamt that I cut my hair after growing it for over 10 years. Holy shit, I had the same dream last night. I recently decided to grow out my hair. Last night I dreamed I picked up a pair of scissors and awkwardly chopped half of it into a mullet for no reason. I was very relieved to wake up and discover that my hair was all still there. We all recently decided to do this. We are all considering awkwardly chopping it off. Yesterday I dreamt I met myself. He wanted me to guess the song that was playing. I guessed correctly but he told me no and I believed him, damn it. Trust nobody, not even yourself. I was arrested for some reason I don't remember, and the officer had just taken me out of the car and was about to walk me into the station. My hands were cuffed behind my back, and he kept roughing me up for no reason, smacking me on the head, stuff like that. It got worse and worse, and I started getting really mad. Eventually I snapped, and with my hands still bound, I charged him. He fell back and hit his head against the station's brick wall. He fell down to the ground and was completely motionless. Immediately I freaked out, oh my god, he's dead. I'm a cop killer. I'm gonna get executed. The panic woke me up, and it wasn't just a feeling of relief, but like that I got away with it. This might sound really weird, but I had the exact same dream, except the reason I got arrested in my dream was for stealing a Red Bull. My current boyfriend breaking up with me to get married to the girl my ex cheated on me with. She'll keep doing that until she knocks out all of the competition. I dreamed that I had a class in college that I had forgotten that I signed up for and missed like half the class before I remembered. Falling through an infinite abyss. Not the worst dream, but interesting. My school blew up while all the kids were inside, otherwise I wouldn't mind. I had a dream once fairly recently that I was at my aunt's house and all my family was there. I kept saying we need to wait for X, my husband, and everyone kept giving me weird looks, till they finally sat me down and said X doesn't exist, he's never existed, you're still with abusive X. I've never been more happy to wake up from a nightmare, and I often have night terrors involving the traumas I've already been through. Dreamt that there was a guy with a knife stabbed in the chest. Instead of what I would do like a normal person and call the police or something, I evilly stuck the knife deeper and grinned like I was a different person, like a psychotic demon if you will. It is one of those not what happened to me but what I did that disturbed me and I filed it as a nightmare. That or the one when my balls fell out. Take your pick. Basically any time that I experience sleep paralysis. Happens to me a lot. Try focusing on wiggling your toes as soon as possible. Seems to help me the most. If I realize it's happening soon enough, wiggling my toes can get me out of the experience before the creepy lady comes out. I had sleep paralysis once. I felt a presence lean over me where I was laying with my eyes closed and breathed heavily. At first I thought it was one of my children, but then realized I couldn't move and remembered reading about sleep paralysis earlier. So I knew what was happening, but it was still scary as hell. What was your dream so terrible that you were glad it was just a dream? Leave a comment. And subscribe to this channel if you wanna see more same videos.